Yes, indeed. I'm just still listening. I'm just having my head Wayne Dawson freestyling.
Yeah, that was suit. Good.
That was embarrassing.
We'll replay that for Scott.
No, please don't. That was embarrassing.
Yes. And just for the record, Sissy and Christy,
yes.
There are a very high number of women rappers who are recognized here.
Of course.
Here, so you guys
awesome.
Should feel free to freestyle too. I'm not going to put you on the spot, but I'm just saying.
Okay.
You can feel free to freestyle
all
too,
right.
But not now. All right.
Okay.
Okay. We'll talk about that later.
Yep.
That's another show. All right. But the show we are now, holla if you hear me, 50 years of hip hop, which is amazing, right here at the Rock Hall, just opened. They had a tremendous opening night. Some of the biggest stars in hip hop over the years were here. And then, Joe, we're going across this wall, and you, me, my engineer, Bob, my photographer, Lamont, all of us are going through different influences in hip hop we've had.
Yeah, this area here that we're talking about is alternative hip hop, so yep. Some of the socially conscious artists. We talk about, you know, we were talking about De La Soul a little bit ago.
Right.
Then Yo-Yo, we were mentioning with the jacket mm-hmm. over there. You know, getting
one of
the
your favorites when you were growing up, Busta
yes.
Rhymes.
I used to love the fisheye lens that he would shoot right. with the big oversized outfits. I was a big Busta Rhymes fan, so it was really awesome to get to include this here. Now, we got a big fan of you.
Yeah.
You're a
Outkast.
Big fan here.
I'm
yes.
a huge Outkast fan because there were two different genres of hip hop. They came together to create sounds and music and everything that no one even really, I mean, you look at them, you see how opposite they are, you know, and so
yeah.
they did a great job. Almost everybody knows a Outkast song, but we're in 216. But first of all, the Miseducation of Lauryn Hill changed the game and the face of hip hop, didn't it?
Yeah, I mean, that album is a seminal album within the entire trajectory of rock and roll and hip hop, and certainly we were talking.
Yeah.
Feel free to bust into song, you know, the lady artist in the exhibit. Certainly Lauryn Hill needed to be someone who's representative for talking about
and
it.
Then over here, some Cleveland influences in hip hop over the years, and there are a few.
Certainly.
Okay.
I mean, I think the one that comes to mind, Bone Thugs and Harmony,
mm-hmm.
for sure.
Yeah.
And
mm-hmm.
so we've got some of their effects on the exhibit. And then, of course, we were talking Uchi Kuchi and MC Brains.
Yeah.
You had an encounter with him semi-recent here.
Yeah,
and,
very nice guy. I met him. Met him out. He was very, very cool. Look at that. And then on the opposite side here, we have some more Cleveland influences, don't we?
Yeah, certainly. You know, MGK has sort of taken a bit of a diversion away from the hip hop,
mm-hmm.
but at the same time, he has songs that are out. We've got Kid Cudi as well. People are probably aware
yeah,
that he's
yeah.
from the area,
yes.
and so we wanted to make sure that those artists were included if we were going to talk about hip hop in Cleveland.
Well, you got to do it, man. Got to do it. That is so cool. The exhibit goes through the end of the year.
Yes.
Most definitely. People should definitely come and check it out. I mean, again, we're just scratching the surface, tip of the iceberg, but there's so much education here. It's so great. Well done, Joe. Well done, sir.
Thank you.
Well done.
Appreciate
it was you. Great going down memory lane. Okay, two turntables and a microphone right there. You can see if you have skills. I tried. Yeah, I tried in college. Guess what? Didn't work. But I will say this, as we go back to you guys in the studio, I did buy this Panasonic Jambox back in the day. I bought it at Sears. I can't remember how much it was.
Sears.
But I actually had this Jambox,
wow.
you guys. This cassette. Oh, my gosh. Isn't that crazy?
That's crazy.